Yeah, semiconductor technology is a critical technology when you think about the challenges of the next generations. When you think about the big societal challenges where it's an aging population, so we need to provide the world with better life science technology. When you think about the challenge that we have to deal with raw materials and the reuse of materials, think about climate change. If you think about these semiconductors needed to make sure that we can generate enough solar power, that we can generate enough wind power, and then how do we collect that energy, and how do we store it, and how do we distribute it through a smart grid? Semiconductors are everywhere, and it will only grow. I think the semiconductor industry will grow from last year about $600 billion of sales to what we think over $1 trillion by 2030. You know, it took us 40 years to build an industry that can sell $600 billion worth of semiconductors, but the next 8 to 10 years, it's going to more than double. Yeah? So that is why, because semiconductors are basically used in every segment of life. It's essential to a modern society. When we got involved with Trumpf, was with our EUV technology. So, and in fact, it wasn't ASML, it was a supplier of ASML, it was Cymer, as a company that we acquired. And they were involved with Trumpf because they were looking at the leader in laser technology. And they ended up with Trumpf, and that turned out to be the right choice. So in that sense, we actually were very acquainted and with the let's say southern Germany, the Stuttgart area technology companies, Carl Zeiss is not that far away in Oberkochen. So we were quite familiar with the capabilities of the German industry in the south of Germany. Trumpf was actually easy for us because it's a technology company. We're a high-tech company also. And when you put two high-tech companies together and you basically create a big challenge, then you see things happen. I think when you look to the future, it's very difficult to predict the technology that are needed to create the next future. It's basically a question with ASML now for almost 25 years, and people are asking me the question, and especially our shareholders and our investors, Peter, what is the next killer application? What's the next technology that's going to create all that value? And I always have the same answer. I don't know. I have no idea. But what I do know is that way we invest in the fundamentals of technology, in this particular case, the continuation of Moore's law, if we do that, which actually means that every 2 to 3 years, in the semiconductor industry, we can reduce the cost of a transistor, the cost of a function, with 50%, then somebody's going to find a solution and find a product and an application for that cost reduction. Or when it's the same cost, you have twice the function or three times the function. So you create value. Now, this is I think it's very much the human ingenuity, the creativity, that will create the next level of technology. But you need to do one thing. You need to make sure that the basic technology, the basic research, provides you with the technologies that translates into value. Yeah? And then you'll be surprised. It's clear in my mind that the world is bifurcating, that the world is partly deglobalizing. And it's the result of what we found out when we had to face COVID. COVID-19 or Corona, we just figured out that we are very dependent on certain raw materials and we can't make vaccines. And then suddenly we also start to realize this with semiconductors. And trust me, when we think about the energy transition and the new technologies needed there, storage and battery, we'll probably figure out that there is a level of dependence, single-sided dependence, that you need to really scratch your head and say, do we want this to this level? Or do we want to create some level of mutual dependency? The way that we work with our suppliers like Zeiss and Trumpf, it's mutual dependence, and that's great, because then you make progress. So you need to stay relevant, yeah? So independence, full independence is a dream. You shouldn't do that. It's not efficient. But you need to stay relevant, relevant in the context of mutual dependency. Europe has its own role to play in this bifurcation, this you could say this part of deglobalization. We go from the global village down to a village that will have separate parts. Yeah? ASML, with its partners like Carl Zeiss and Trumpf, we are unique. Yeah, we are, you know, the world depends on European technology. So what we need to do is we need to make sure that from a European government point of view, we provide the incentives and the conditions so that the semiconductor industry in Europe, which is still relevant, stays relevant. Which actually also means that for semiconductor manufacturing, we probably need to step up and we need to invite the big semiconductor makers of this world, the TSMCs, the Infineons, and the Intels, and perhaps, you know, some other players to come to Europe and to start European semiconductor manufacturing. Because the European customer base is also here. It's the Nokias, the Ericssons, the Siemenses, the NXPs, then the automotive. The customers are here. So Europe needs to realize that semiconductors are going to be essential and that we need to stay relevant. And this is why investments, government regulations, and even subsidies are a very viable instrument to get there. What you're seeing today is that sustainability, of course, is very much a topic, and it's very important. You know, because yes, we have created in the semiconductor industry specifically, but I think our generation, my generation, the old generation, like my daughter says, the people with the gray hair, you know, these people have created indeed a global village. Our generation has created a global village, you know, where basically we've created the internet, we've created global travel, we've created ecosystems without any borders. Yeah, that has created massive amounts of higher standards of living. We've pulled hundreds of millions of people out of poverty. But we also forgot a few things, you know, by doing this. We, of course, created issues that are now creating, you know, climate change, yeah? And which we didn't think of, which, of course, the younger generation would look at us and said, we blame you guys for what you did. Yeah, we didn't think about everything. But now we have to deal with the consequences. So sustainability, when it comes to environment, yeah, extremely important, but also social and governance. I mean, the way that we take responsibility for what we do is very important. Yeah? We are an integral part of a society. And when you think about sustainability, and you think about energy usage and the energy transition and the role of semiconductors in this, then yes, semiconductor manufacturing itself is highly energy intensive. But the indirect, the downstream effect of smarter semiconductors using far and far less energy, yeah, to help solve some of these big societal problems, which the energy transition is one of them, is also clear that the follow-on, the second or third order effect of semiconductor manufacturing on helping to solve the climate change issues is also very, very clear. It's very positive.